Walt Disney presents Disney's Christmas Fantasy on Ice. Starring three-time world champion Kurt Browning, silver medalist Peter and Kitty Carruthers, gold medalist Gordeeva and Grinkov, gold medalist Scott Hamilton, silver medalist Nancy Kerrigan, gold medalist Katarina Witt, also starring Bronson Pinchot, and all your favorite Disney friends.
Deck the halls with boughs of holly, fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. Tis the season to be jolly, fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. Don we now our gay apparel, fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la. Throw the ancient Yuletide carol, fa-la-la-la-la-la-la-la-la.
Alice.
And the Haunted Mansion, yeah. And the Pirates of the Caribbean.
I know, but you know what's great? Right now, Uncle Bronnie's gonna take a fun break. Isn't it fun? Come here.
We gotta move. You promised.
Alice.
Mom and Dad heard you.
All right, now, you know what? Alice, listen to me. First of all, bringing Mom and Dad into this is cruel and unusual. And I want to tell you something. I need to sit down on a bench of some kind. And there's a bench right over there. So why don't you and I go sit down on the bench, and Uncle Bronnie will tell you one of his famous award-winning stories.
You never won an award. And I want to go to Mickey's Toontown because I've never seen it.
How about Uncle Bronnie's bench town?
Come on.
Boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Here we are. Oh. At Uncle Bronnie's bench town.
Just tell me the story.
Okay. It's really Christmassy here at Disneyland, isn't it?
Sure. I wish it would snow.
What do you mean? How can it snow? We're in Southern California. It doesn't snow here.
It's the Magic Kingdom.
Oh, it's the Magic Kingdom. Well, of course it is. Did I ever tell you about the time it snowed in Disneyland?
No.
You want to hear about the time it snowed in Disneyland?
Okay.
Well, there was a little girl named Alice.
Allison
was her name. No connection to yours whatsoever. And she wanted it to snow really badly in Disneyland, just like you do. So she mentioned this to...
Mickey Mouse?
Right, Mickey Mouse. How did you know that?
I don't know.
So Mickey Mouse and his friends went off through the woods in search of the one person who could make it snow. The Wizard of Winter, the King of Cool, the Father of Freeze, Jack Frost.
If this is about that nose nipping, it wasn't done with malicious intent. It's part of the job, okay? Peace. Just kidding. Come on in.
Once Mickey and his friends were inside this strange little man's cabin, Jack listened while Snow White explained the reason for their visit.
We're here to answer a little girl's wish. She'd like it to snow just once for Christmas in Disneyland.
Oh, Disneyland, California. Well, let me get right on that. I'm sorry, I'm just kind of stuck a little bit here. Disneyland. Boy, that's an iceberg of an order. The old man's. Yeah. Make it snow at Disneyland, you gotta have a... You paying attention? You gotta have a magic snowflake and a little girl's wish. Well, you've got half the recipe right there. Hey, but wait, just wait a minute. This gets a little bit more difficult than that. Let me show you this. The thing is, this snowflake thing, you've got a nice thick room here. It's going to be a little bit more difficult. Now let me explain this to you. Okay, there are 6 points to the snowflake. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You've got to go and get a point of the snowflake. Each point is guarded by a guardian of the snowflake.
Where are the guardians?
In the ice world. You see right there the whole caption. It's been sitting right in front of you. You've got to go there, and you've got to get 1 point of the snowflake and bring it back here.
We better go right away.
Okay, good, people. You see, Snow gets my drift. Snow, come here. You've got to go to the ice world and don't slip up. Go.
So Snow White set off for the forest to find the first point of the snowflake.
She went with Dopey, right?
Right. And soon they came upon the first ice world and some friends who looked very familiar. Yeah.
find the first point of the snowflake.
That's right, Alice. So Snow White and Dopey continued searching. Next, they came upon a beautiful magic princess. And that is how Snow White and Dopey got the first point of the snowflake. Meanwhile, Jack was getting ready to send out the next pair of travelers.
You want some? I call it cold cut. Anyway, don't stand there like a couple of chipmunks. Look, I gotta show you something. Come over here. You see this little lodge? Yeah, it's right down in here that you'll find your guardian of the snowflake. Just anywhere where there's children and ice. Just keep searching, searching. They're bound to turn up.
Chip and Dale were delighted.
But did they get their snowflake?
Not yet, Alice.
Thank you.
finally, the second point of the snowflake was theirs.
I like this story, Uncle Bronnie.
I'm glad, Alice.
On the first day of Christmas, my true love sent to me a partridge in a pear tree. On the second day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
two turtle doves
and a partridge in a pear tree. On the third day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
three French hens,
two turtle doves
and a partridge in a pear tree. On the fourth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
four woolly birds,
three French hens,
two turtle doves
and a partridge in a pear tree. On the fifth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me five gold rings,
four calling birds,
three French hens,
two turtle doves,
and a partridge in a pear tree. On the sixth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
six kiss a lady,
five gold rings,
four calling birds,
three French hens,
two turtle doves,
and a partridge in a pear tree.
On the seventh day of Christmas, my true love sent to me
seven swans a swimming,
six geese a laying,
five gold rings,
four calling birds,
three French hens,
two turtle doves,
and a partridge in a pear tree.
On the eighth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me eight maids a milking, seven swans a swimming, six geese a laying,
five gold rings,
four calling birds, three French hens, two turtle doves, and a partridge in a pear tree.
On the ninth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me nine drummers drumming.
On the tenth day of Christmas, my true love sent to me ten pipers piping.
Nine drummers drumming.
Ten pipers piping.
Drumming.
Piping.
Drumming. Eight maids a milking,
seven swans a swimming,
six geese a laying,
five gold rings,
four calling birds,
three French hens,
two turtle doves,
and a partridge in a pear tree.
On the 11th day of Christmas, my true love sent to me 11 ladies dancing, 10 pipers piping, 9 drummers drumming, 8 maids a milking, 7 swans a swimming, 6 geese a laying, 5 gold rings, 4 calling birds, 3 French hens, 2 turtle doves, and a partridge in a pear tree.
On the 12th day of Christmas, my true love sent to me 12
lords are leaping, ladies dancing,
10
pipers piping,
9
drummers drumming,
8
maids are milking,
7
swans are swimming,
6
geese are laying,
5 gold rings,
4 calling birds,
3 French hens,
2 turtle doves,
and a partridge in a pear tree. And a partridge in a pear tree.
With 2 points of the snowflake in place, Belle and the Beast waited to see where they would be sent.
I guess it's our turn now.
That's right, Belle!
What are you doing?
Making slush. It's a dirty job, but somebody's got to do it. Well, we did the easy part, the snow. Now it's time for the muck. We delicately tint it. Today I'm going a little extra heavy because this is for Midtown Manhattan. And now, we come to my trademark, the frost. Speaking of which, it's time for a nip. Oh. Okay, off to the ice world with ya. Now is the winter of my discontent. Oh, that's cold.
So Belle and the Beast went off to find the next guardian.
Hey, who's telling this story, Alice?
Come on, Uncle Bronnie, keep up.
Tale as old as time. nice it can be. Barely even friends, then somebody bends unexpectedly.
Just a little change, small to say the least, but the little scare neither one prepared. Beauty and the Beast, ever as before, ever just as sure as the sun will rise. Oh, 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 till as long.
So now Beauty and the Beast finally had their point of the magic snowflake.
Well, Uncle Bronnie, I think that's the prettiest one so far.
Hey, Alice? Where are we?
We're in Mickey's Toontown, where Mickey's friends live. Isn't it terrific?
Yeah, it's great. Where do we sit?
So what happened next, Uncle Bronnie?
Well, I'm not quite sure what you're talking about here.
The story. What happened in the story?
They all lived happily ever after. Is there a rest station of some kind around the corner, maybe?
Uncle Bronnie, wait! That's not the end of the story. They only found 3 points of the snowflake so far.
Well, suppose I tell you the rest of the story while we sit here.
Suppose we take a ride on the Toontown trolley.
So Jack Frost sent out his next team of scouts to the forest. But not just any forest. Oh no, the magic forest. Don't you want to know which magic forest? The underwater forest.
Ariel, listen to me. The human world, it's a mess. Life under the sea is better than anything they got up there. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more is you looking for? Under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day. Out in the sun, they slave away. While we're devoting full time to floating under the sea. Now here all the fish is happy as off through the waves they roll. The fish on the land ain't happy. The shark 'cause they in the bowl. But fish in the bowl is lucky. They in for a worse of fate. One day when the boss get hungry.
Yes, you got me on the plate.
What no, under the sea. Under the sea, nobody beat us, fry us, and eat us in fricassee.
We Woodland folks loves to cook. Under the sea we have to hook up. We got no trouble. Life is the bubbles under the sea.
Under the sea.
Under the sea.
Under the sea.
Since life is sweet here, we got to be here naturally.
Naturally.
Even the sturgeon and the ray, did it, the earth can start to play. We got the spirit, you got to hear it, under the sea. Play the flute, the cop, play the harp, the place, play the bass, and the sound, the job, the bass, play the brass, the chub, play the tub. The flute is the duke of soul.
Yeah.
The rake, he can play the lings on the strings. The trout rocking out the blackfish. He sings this belt and this front. They know where it's at. They know that blowfish blow. We got a hot crustacean band. Each little clam here know how to jam here under the sea. Each little slug here cutting a rug here under the sea. Each little snail here know how to wail here. That's why it's hotter under the water. Yeah, we in luck here down in the muck here under the
Roger and Goofy have the fourth point of the snowflake. What about Mickey and Minnie?
Oh, Jack had a special bit of magic dreamed up for them in a whole new world.
When Mickey and Minnie found their point of the magic snowflake, that meant there was just one more to go. The final point of the magic snowflake was at hand. Donald Duck and Pluto were hot on the trail.
Thank you.
Donald and Pluto finally had the last point of the magic snowflake, the end.
So did it snow, Uncle Bronnie?
You know, all this storytelling's made me pretty hungry. You want some popcorn, Alice?
Okay.
Okay. You sit right here and wait for me, all right?
Okay.
Just stay right there.
I wish it would snow. I wish it would snow. I wish it would snow.
Alice, it's snowing!
Great story, Uncle Bronnie!
Yeah, well,
Merry Christmas!